horse, people. Part two. Here we go with the good horse and the bad humans.
Rick, why are you always picking?
Notice her flag is always from behind her when she's pushing it. Maybe somebody told her that. I don't care if it's behind and it makes it smaller and you don't need to use it all the time. I'm okay with that. But when you use it, make that damn thing mean something. Put it forward, especially if a horse is showing his butt and trying to kick you. This horse says, I don't need to listen. You don't even know what the hell you're doing. You run around with that damn flag acting like you know what you're doing. You don't know what you're doing. I know what I'm doing. I'm the one that's controlling this damn monkey show. What the hell?
Keep going.
That's why this horse confused. This is why it pushes back. Confused, frustration, threatening. Did she just back away from that horse again after that kick? She did. She backed away as soon as it kicked. Even if she didn't back away. Rick, she didn't back away. Because this is what owners always tell me when I tell them that shit. They're like, well, I wasn't backing away. This is her talking. Here, I'm going to answer it for you, mama. I wasn't backing away. I was moving to try and get in front of the drive line, and I was trying to move, and it may look like I was backing away, but I wasn't backing away. I don't care what you were doing. It looked like you were backing away. Therefore, you told the horse you were backing away. Therefore, the horse sees it as you're scared. I don't care what you were really doing. I care what the horse sees and thinks. That's how the horse learns. The horse doesn't learn from what you meant to do, from how you can explain what you were doing, how you tell me how I saw it wrong and how the horse saw it wrong and how everybody's wrong. The horse only cares what it sees.
This way, Star.
This way, this talking, keep your mouth shut. You don't need to talk. This way doesn't mean anything. This nagging just shows frustration. It shows that you're out of control. It allows you to communicate with your mouth. And when you're communicating with your mouth, that means you're not focusing on what your body is saying. Focus on what your body is saying. If you want the horse to go this way, don't say this way. Put pressure on a horse to where the only way the horse can go is the way you want it to go. Talk to the horse with language, body language, not mouth language. Oh, shit. I'm still hosing my water. I drowned in my damn app. I gotta go turn off my water. I'll be right back. Oh, wrong button. All right, I'm back. I did some jumping jacks. So if I'm out of breath, I just ran up the stairs and did some jumping jacks. First day I really felt good. Woo, feels so good to be able to do something. All right, here we go.
So we're definitely getting some attitude now.
Attitude, the horse look. He's being a horse. He's out there, he wants to be with his friend. You're kind of putting pressure on him. You're confusing him. You're not being clear. This horse works really well when it's online and close and gets good direction. When you let it free and you don't have good control and you don't give good direction, this is what you get. This is not a horse problem, people. I'm almost noticing a little bit. I can't tell if it's because she's throwing her head, but does she look a little, limpy in the left front, maybe? It almost seems like she's short-stepping with this left front. I'm not trying to make excuses that she's in pain and this is acceptable and all this. I just kind of noticed that real quick, out of corner of my eye. We'll ignore that. Very bad direction. Look at this. Watch this direction. Horse is going, and she just points. The drive line is at the neck and shoulder area. If you're not in front of that, you're not going to change the horse's direction. So with her standing way back here, this is not good direction. The horse knows, not only do I not have to listen, you can't make me listen. You're too far to even move on and correct me. Therefore, I get to see if you really want me to go this way, because I'm not going to. And then if you run in and wave your little flag and yell at me and tell me, no, this way, then maybe I'll go that way. But here, you have no ability to enforce what you're doing, and you don't have the respect or control of this horse. And I'm not saying that's a good or bad thing. I'm not sure the horse should respect you as a strong leader, because you're not looking like a strong leader right now. You're not clear. You're over... I don't know if anal's the right word. You're hypersensitive of things when you're walking with a rope. When you can control it, you nag and you're like, because you're close and you got the rope on it. But when you're off, your directions are freaking weak and wild and kind of crazy.
You're up. You're up.
Who thinks this woman could work this horse without this flag? I don't think she could. This is a crutch. It's become the only way that she can communicate, which is a big sign that if you can't communicate with your horse without something like that. Now look, every horse, I mean, if I walk out in pasture and try to do something my horse, they're going to say no. Mr. T will always say no and say, get away from me, I don't want to be caught. So I'm not saying there's not times when you need aids, but if you've had this horse for 6 or 7 years, and you still need a flag, I call that a problem with you, not the horse. Oh man. See, right here, that thing needs to be flapping right here in front at top speed. As fast as she was slapping the hand in her eye, when she didn't need to do that, this flag ought to be slapping this horse's butt and tail and making contact and swinging and making whipping noise like, holy shit, that flag's going fast. She ought to be moving in and getting closer so she can hit this horse instead of staying away so she doesn't hit the horse. Fatal error here, teaching a horse to kick and threaten you. You have to reach out and give that horse some negative feelings when it does this shit.
Hey.
Oh, she said, hey, that always helps. I'm sorry. I missed that part. See, I didn't know she said, hey, let me go back and listen to that. Cause I can tell it's so effective.
Hey,
and then the horse kicks. Who thinks, hey, did anything but allow her to run her mouth and not focus on what she should have been focusing on. Instead of saying, hey, she should have been swinging and attacking that butt. And she wasn't. Mm-hmm. And she still isn't. The horse kicks at her.
Hey.
And she doesn't go after it. She doesn't charge it. She doesn't do anything. She stands there and allows the horse to set up and go, oh, I think I might be in charge. Shit, I just kicked at her. And she ain't even coming in. She's not coming in to correct me. She's not coming in telling me no. She's not making me move my feet. She's standing back. In the horse's mind, it is higher. And she just proved it. People, you have to get in. Stop getting into techniques and flags and what somebody told me. And you have to think like a horse and what the horse is seeing and how they communicate and what they see from what you're doing, not what you see, not what you want, not what you wish, not what you think, but what the horse sees. The horse sees no repercussions from just kicking at you. This is a total human problem. Total human problem. This horse is confused. He's frustrated. He doesn't have a leader. He's got a horse over here calling from him that he feels safe with. He doesn't do this when he's with the other horse. Why is that? Because they communicate and they know the rules and they know the hierarchy. He only does this with the stupid human that doesn't know, that thinks she knows, that has a big flag, but is just not getting it. Not once has she connected with that horse. Maybe she's going to connect with it here. Oh, man. Oh, hell no. Hell no. This horse, this is the problem. I don't have to watch any more of the video. This is a stinking problem. She does not know what danger and what lessons she is teaching this horse by not attacking it. If this rake was right here and that horse kicked at me, I would pick that freaking rake up and throw it at that horse and hit its feet and let it kick it. I don't care where it poked it. He would get that stick up his butt if I could. If you turn your butt and kicking me, A horse does not want to kick at me if I have something to reach out and throw or kick at. If there was a chair there, he would have that chair on him. You do not let a horse kick at you without serious repercussions and making that horse immediately run off like, oh shit, that wasn't the right answer. I don't want to do that again because I get some serious crazy pressure from this stupid human. That's what you want the horse to think when they do this shit. Not this flag waving, this, hey, 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 go this, hey, 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 don't do that. Hey, stop. Hey, you better not kick at me. Hey, hey, hey. This is how you make dangerous horses. This should be a video on how to make a dangerous horse. Who thinks she's scared of this horse? Raise your hand. If your hand's up, you're correct. She's absolutely, I don't even care if she tells me she's not afraid of this horse. She's scared of this horse. Every time he kicks and does that, she does not go in. She's ready to run. She creates this. If this horse figures out that all I need to do is kick and back up, like good smart horses do, he will run her out of this round pen. And that'll be the last time she rounds pin him. She's lucky this horse is not aggressive and hasn't figured out and doesn't know that he can run her out of the round pen. Because I guarantee you, I assure you with 100%, this horse can run her out of the round pen whenever it wants. It just hasn't done it yet. Oh my God. This horse is so fresh. Poor little thing. He's just like, look, I'm in charge. I don't have to listen to you. You can run over here and have your little hissy fit with your little pink flag, whatever it is, whatever color. I don't care. You can have all the hissy fits you want. I'm telling you, I don't have to listen to you. I can run around. I can kick at you. I can threaten you. And there ain't nothing you're going to do about it. How do I know that? Because I've been doing it for 6 years. Now, I guarantee you in her mind, she's like, well, I corrected it with the flag and the horse knows. And don't you see how good it is, Rick, when it's on the rope? It never does this. This horse is telling you what it really thinks of you. Here and now. See, when you have the advantage and you can bully it because you have a rope on it, and you can dominate his head, and you can hit it with the end of the rope, or you can hang your rope hand underneath it and wiggle it around and make it listen to you, you think that you have control. I'm telling you right now, this horse telling you, you ain't nothing to him but a harassment and a frustration source.
Whenever you want to stop with her, it's fine.
All right. Yeah, because we ain't getting no progress. All we're doing is teaching the horse the same damn bad lesson. See, this is where people end up getting caught. Oh, I round pinned my horse. You haven't taught that horse anything but how to kick at you, how to disrespect you, how it doesn't have to listen to you, how you're not going to correct it when it does kick at you, how you're afraid of the horse. That's the only thing the horse is learning. Why do you want to continue teaching it that? You know why? Because she doesn't know she's teaching it. She thinks she's a smart human. All humans think they're smart humans. And that's the problem. They work with smart horses. And they already know they're not smart humans.
Okay, so I'll go ahead and come in now. So,
yeah, oh, she dropped that flag and she went back and got that rake, huh?
Do what you're saying.
Yeah, that horse is still like, oh, you ain't got your flag now, huh? You think you're all bad? Let's play. You want to play? You ain't got your flag now. Let's play. At some point, Star came and stood at the gate. Okay. I'm going to bump forward here. Oh, shit. I didn't want to go that far forward. I didn't want to bump forward past to where you came in there.
I don't want to do...
All right. Let me bump forward here.
You want to stop? I'll go ahead. I don't want to do...
Okay. I wanted to go 5 seconds forward. I moved the thing.
Because I want to see where I can just... I'm not leaving all that.
Is the horse named Star? Did I see Star? Yes, with Star. Okay, so I'll start calling the horsey Star. Aw, Rick, how can you pick on that poor little horse's name Star? It's like a twinkle, twinkle little star, and I gave it cookies, and it loves me. Okay. So Amanda's got a little bit longer reach, it looks like. Is that a whip?
So kind of one of the first things I'm going to do with her is I'm going to work on getting her to move.
Ah, Amanda's got a whip. So Amanda can reach out and have some contact. And show some love to that ass when that horse shows it. Let's see if she does it. I hope she does.
Around and work. I've got some behind her. confused. Feeling with a little thing, I want to keep her going in one direction.
Now somebody who doesn't know will be like, if I wanted to convince this woman that, you know, this horse is really dangerous and you're going to get hurt and you should only have me work with it and this horse. I mean, it would be very easy to convince her of that. But to be honest, I don't think Mama realizes that this horse is going to progress sooner or later and kick her. One day she's going to be off her game or get distracted, or her husband's going to call, or she's going to hear a car crash, or the other horse will trip and fall, and she will turn and look and stop paying attention to that horse, and Star, who has been kicking at her all this time, will continue to do it, and this time it will connect. And it'll kick her in the head and kill her or break her shoulder or whatever, and then they'll want to put the horse down because it's dangerous. She's making the horse dangerous. She's doing this horse a disservice by allowing this horse to do this. And somebody's going to say, well, you're being mean if you hit it, and it needs a hug, and it needs a timeout. Well, then you go train your horses your way. I ain't giving horses hugs that are kicking at me. They ain't getting cookies, we ain't friends, and we ain't buddies, and they're going to know it, and they're going to be scared of me if they kick at me. And I'm going to make them scared of me. Rick, you should never make a horse scared because they should love you, and you got to love it. Yeah, well, that's because you're an idiot.
Until I decide to turn her. We're both outside her and outside. Clinton Anderson versus... Then I'll get out.
All right. Nope. I want to go back to where you're getting to move. Okay, so the horse moving. See how she can kind of get that rope a little bit closer?
So
that whip's making a... I'm not saying a whip is good in this situation. A whip is good because the owner has desensitized her to the flag. The flag means nothing.
She comes in or farther out right now.
Why isn't the horse kicking at her? Rick, the horse likes green and... And if you wear green, it's calming, and that's why the horse isn't kicking. Yeah, well, that's because you're an idiot, too. People come in here with freaking colors and shit.
So when I'm working her around me, I notice that you have a tendency to look at her head, which is pretty common because people watch that to see what...
Now, a little bit, this horse is going to be a little frustrated. There's some good and bad here. When the owner working this horse, let the horse get a lot of piss and vinegar out of it. So the horse is more likely to be a little bit calmer now. So it may not give the reaction right away. But once Amanda, I'm predicting, I haven't watched this video yet. Once Amanda starts putting more pressure, I have a feeling that more pressure is going to make the horse show its resistance. But we'll see.
What kind of reaction they're going to get. Because when you start staring at their head.
Looks like the horse doing pretty good for her. Notice how my forward energy inadvertently slows when I stare at her face, further confusing her. Well, if you stare at the face or in front of the drive line, remember your eyes are almost like a force field. It shows a line. And when I want a horse to move forward, I'm always staring here. I never look at the head or face. I'm always staring at the shoulder or right at this neck area because that's forward momentum. And I'm always behind this neck and shoulder area to push the horse forward. If I move in front of this shoulder and neck area, then the horse will either stop or turn because I get in front of that drive line. Same way in a wild, if you see a stallion gathering up a mare or you see a mare gathering up a baby, they cut off their drive line and make the horse turn, stop, or yield. That shows that they know what they're doing, they're stronger, and they can move faster, and they can get in front of that drive line. If a horse can prevent you from getting in front of the drive line, then he knows you're not smarter, stronger, or faster, and he will start ignoring you, which is what happened when the owner was working. The horse knew she couldn't get in front of driveline, cut her off. She can just say hey and wave her flag real hard.
And now she starts to say, what do you know, you can see already, she's like, well, what do you want? You want me to stop?
Okay, so Amanda's really got this horse kind of locked on here. It almost looks like she's got it on a lead rope, but she doesn't. The horse is really locked on. The head's staying close, and the horse is really kind of disengaged. She's made her circle smaller. Instead of chasing the horse and allowing the horse to dictate, this horse is kind of locked on her. Why? Because it's probably getting clearer directions. It understands what's being asked of it, so it gives it. It knows that this horse person knows what they're doing, so I can't get away with all my shenanigans, so I will listen. I mean, you can totally see it in the horse. The horse didn't change, per se, in this. The stupid humans changed. We changed one stupid human for another stupid human. But this stupid human knows what it's doing because the horse says it. Not because I'm saying it. Not because Amanda says it, not because somebody else says it. The horse tells me that she respects and understands this person better, which tells me the stupid human is doing better. If the horse does better, the human does better. When the horse does bad, it's because the human does bad.
And now I'm going to direct my attention to her hind quarters.
Good correction. Good pressure. Yes. 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 Her footing wasn't good. She couldn't get closer to hit that horse. But there was no hesitation. As soon as that horse kicked, Amanda turned in to the wicked barn witch of the West and was on that horse's ass, which is exactly what she should have done. I wish she could have got close enough to leave a mark on that ass. If you hit a horse once, the odds are you won't have to hit it again. The problem is most people can't pull the trigger and hit a horse because they want to be kind and they don't want to hurt it and they don't want to make it scared of it. They want to be friends and they love their horse and they want their horse to love them. And if I hit it, it won't ever love me because that's what I thought. And I just need to time out and give it hugs and cookies and whatever. People, once you hit a horse, the odds are you won't have to hit it again because the horse learns.
And now I'm going to direct my attention to...
Watch how quick Amanda reacts to this kick. Immediate freaking... Oh, hell no. Boom! Hear that whip? That noise and whipping is putting pressure. Even though she's not hitting it, her movement, her chasing, you didn't see her back up. You didn't see her pause. You didn't see her stand flat-footed and allow her to get away with it. She immediately put pressure and charged and moved toward the horse. Now, a lot of people will say, well, ring of a horse is kicking you and you move to it, you're going to get kicked and that's dangerous and you shouldn't do that, right? Yeah, you should move into the kick zone, but you still need to put that forward pressure. If you can use that flag or that whip or your hands or a rope or a something you can throw, a bucket, anything, you've got to put pressure and make this horse think you're charging and chasing it. Even if you don't chase it directly, charge toward it to put pressure. Even though she's not able to catch it and she can't get it, she's moving forward. There's no confusion. This horse can no way misinterpret that my kicking made her stand still or move away. This horse knows that kicking got a crazy woman chasing me, and I don't like that. That's what it needs to know. That horse like, oh shit, this never happened. What the hell? This woman's crazy. See, the horse don't have good footing too, which is good. I'm glad. I want this horse thinking, oh shit, this crazy human won't let me kick at it. It chases the shit out of me. Holy shit, I don't want to do that again. This is what you want. Good job, Amanda. I was a little worried when Amanda contacted me because I didn't know who she was. I mean, she could have been some barn witch that thought she knew everything and didn't know shit. So when somebody contacts me like that, I mean, hopefully I have faith that if they're watching me, they probably get it. Because the people that don't watch me don't get it and they don't want to hear it and they don't want to be told and they don't like the way I say it. So they'd rather remain stupid than learn. So the people that leave, I automatically know they don't get it. But the people that hang around, I think, get it because they have a little bit thicker skin. They can understand horses. They can listen. They may not like the way I say it. They may not like my tone. They may not like my sharp tongue. But they get that. I know what I'm talking about. What I say works. So they will hang around because they know it's going to help them. So that's the difference. So when Amanda says, you know, because she was watching me and was on my videos and said that she would volunteer to help, in the back of my mind, it was like, shit, I hope Amanda isn't just like someone else that's going to go out there and do all this bad shit. Now I sent somebody that don't know shit because I don't know who they are. And now they're going to help somebody that don't know shit. And I could have created a damn shitstorm. But this right here, this one thing that Amanda did, I haven't seen anything that Amanda did yet. But this one thing tells me she gets it. When a horse threatens you, you freaking give that horse immediate negative pressure and you chase the shit out of it and make sure it knows, you know what? Kicking is not a good thing. And this is what I get. And I don't want this, so I stop kicking. The reason why this horse is still kicking at the owner is because the owner stands there, allows it, is scared of it, and doesn't get it.
Rick, why are you being mean?
Oh, be quiet. Okay. So, now, did Amanda take the pressure a little too much? Eh, maybe. I mean, she chased it, I think, two or three loops. Does it need to be that bad? No. What is really important is the first 10 or 15 seconds after a horse does something wrong, it gets that negative pressure. Doesn't need to go more than 5, 10 seconds normally. They get it. It connects it. If you start dragging it out to 2 or 3 minutes or 30 minutes, or you make the horse run for 15 minutes, you've totally lost the connection of the correction. It becomes harassment and mean, and you're confusing the horse. You want the correction to be fast. You want the timing to be immediate when the bad behavior happened, and you want to make the connection with the horse and then move on and forget it. We're not going to keep holding a grudge. How dare you kick at me? I'm going to make you do this now, and you're going to run, and you're not going to like it. And for the next 20 minutes, you're going to hate your life, and I'm going to show you who's boss. And you don't want that. That's not good. Okay?
I'm going to hit on her case a little bit. I don't need to push it too far, but just to let her know, I'm not going to...
So Amanda looks like she's calming down now. She's walking kind of slow. The horse, I might have, right after this, I'd have probably moved in front of the drive line and made the horse stop and look at me. If this horse stops and looks at me, it's telling me, what do you want me to do? It's telling me it knows that I'm higher. If you just keep chasing it, it's still telling you that it knows you can put pressure on it and it's running, but it hasn't had a chance to stop and stand and kind of connect the dots and see that you're going to be fair and equal. So running it too much here, I would have probably stopped it and see if it stopped and looked at me. Now, maybe if she moves the front drive line, it may stop, immediately turn the other way and start running. That's okay. I changed its directions. I stopped its forward movement. Both those things show dominance. And if it wants to run off the other direction, go ahead. I'll let you run off and I'll follow behind you and keep you moving. And then I'll move in front of the drive line again, see if you want to stop. And then if you want to turn and run off, well, you can do that. But if you want to turn and look at me and ask me what I want next, that's what I really want.
Yeah, you see afterwards, she kind of slings her head a little bit. You know, I'm okay with that.
See, Amanda right here is getting a little bit into, which is hard when you're working. You're trying to teach and work, and you forget that the horse is running around saying, what do you want? Why are you chasing me? Why am I running? Am I doing the right thing? So you're losing the, to me, there was never a break in the correction and the horse's movement to where it's getting so long now, the horse is going to start getting frustrated, like, why am I running? Why do I keep running? That's when the horse starts saying, you know what? Maybe I'll stop running. Maybe she doesn't want me to run. Maybe I don't have to listen. Maybe. And that's telling you he's asking for direction. So right now, because she's talking to the owner and explaining, she's ignoring the horse. Remember, when you're running your mouth, you're not concentrating on your body position and what you're communicating to the horse. That's why when you keep your mouth shut, you're focusing on your body and what the horse is telling you and what you're telling the horse, which is why better horse people tend to keep their mouth shut. Rick, you just say that because women talk a lot and you don't like women. Okay, whatever.
You have perfect sense. Because it's just her saying, you know what, I didn't like that.
Give the horse a break already,
that's
Amanda. Shit.
You know,
quit yapping and pay attention. Stop the horse.
They have a little attitude and stuff. But anyway, back to focusing on her hindquarters.
Let the horse stop. The horse. See, right here, the horse is going to stop on its own in a minute. Because it doesn't know what it wants. And so then you're going to let the horse stop on its own instead of using that as a communication process to where I'm going to see if you're paying attention to me. I'm going to stop you before you ask to stop or before you want to stop, therefore reasserting my dominance and my control. And then you're either going to accept that and run off, or you may stop and look at me. And if you stop and look at me, we may have a moment to where we can just go, okay, do we get it? Neither one of us gets pressure. Neither one of us does anything. Let's see who's in charge. Normally, the horse will say, I don't know what you want me to do. I know you're in charge. And it will stand there and wait for you. That would be a better lesson than letting the horse run, ignoring it, and keep talking, and then make the horse stop on its own and ask, am I doing the right thing? You know, I don't want my horse asking me if I'm doing it. I want my horse to know. Stop making the horse run. Good grief.
As I step around, I'm kind of taking a step or two forward while side seven.
Okay, what is she teaching a horse here? That I can make you run? I mean, somebody may say that's a good thing. It should run. Some people will say by doing this, you're taking a piss and vinegar out. She won't want to kick again. Okay, that is partially true. Me personally, I would rather concentrate on forget the kick. I corrected it. Let's get back to communication. Let's get back to being clear so the horse knows what I want and I can talk to the horse and we can have communication. If it kicks again, I'll deal with it. But I don't want to keep the horse running in a circle for this long with no direction just because I can or just because I'm still upset that it kicked at me. So I disagree with Amanda here. Holy shit, I'm getting tired.
I usually work him in one direction until I see him start to calm a little bit. And then I'll ask him to turn.
Okay, this is really getting way too long. I'm even getting more irritated.
There's a lot of ways that they...
I'm getting frustrated. I'm not even a horse. The horse is like, dude, why do I have to keep running? Why are you harassing me? Why are you being mean to me? Why?
See, like right now she's asking, can I stop?
She is. I'm glad you saw that, Amanda. She's asking. Why don't you communicate and say, hey, if you ask, I'll go ahead and communicate with you.
Is this enough? I want to stop now.
I like the way that she's not being aggressive with the whip when she wants it to go. She's just moving it and kind of looking. She's moving the horse with, you know, with purpose, but with not aggressive meanness. Again, I still think this is too long. Rick, you already said that. I know I said it. I'm going to keep saying it until she stops running the damn horse circle. Oh, shit, I'm at 31 minutes. All right, this is part two. We'll go to part three. Good horsey. Amanda did good on the correction, but I'm going to have to dock a point for too many circles.